Hi guys, my name's Alex Ritz. I'm a certified professional dog trainer with the CCPDT. This is one of my dogs, Windy, and today we're gonna talk to you a little bit about martingale collars. So your typical collar is just a flat buckle collar, circle, can fit right over their head, hold their ID tag, and it's the collar that we tend to be familiar with. A martingale collar, in contrast, has the ability to slightly tighten to prevent escape. So on this collar, it's a regular flat wide collar for most of it. And then we have one part that has chain. A lot of them also have fabric. And the leash gets clipped to this part, this little loop right here. And when it gets pulled, when it gets tightened, the collar size shrinks a little bit. So the purpose of a martingale is not to choke the dog. And in fact, if you're using it where it could choke your dog or as a correction collar, you're using it incorrectly. Instead, it's to help prevent escape. Because like you saw with this collar, it is able to fit over his head. And while it's fitted correctly the way it is right now, I could fit my fingers under, it's not a ton of extra room. It still has the ability to prevent escape if he's a dog that tries to back out of his collar or something like that. And he's got a pretty big head. So if you have a dog like a greyhound or another kind of sight hound, the risk is even greater for them backing out of their collars. So instead, with the martingale, it fits so that it just can slide over their head in the case of this one where it doesn't have a buckle, or in the case of ones that have a buckle, you could buckle it around just like you would a normal collar. And then when it tightens, you notice it's not restricting him in any way. He's still fine. He's just hanging out. It's not choking him. It's not cruel, cutting off air pressure or anything like that. But when it is tight, I can just barely fit fingers underneath and it's not going anywhere. It's going to stay very solid on his head versus a regular collar that could kind of move around and has the potential to slip. So when you walk your dog with a martingale, you just have a little bit extra security that they're not going to back out of their collar, they're not going to escape, anything like that. You watching birds?
Yeah.
Like I said, especially for dogs with small heads, that kind of stuff. With the martingale, I do prefer to only use it when I'm with my dog, walking my dog, have them on leash, rather than using it in a situation like I would a normal collar that he just wears all the time. And that's because it does have this extra little dangling piece that can be a little bit easier to snag on things, especially the chain ones. If my dogs are wrestling and they're chomping at each other, it's easy to get teeth stuck in that chain. So this is a collar that ideally you are using just on walks when you're outside as a little bit of extra safety rather than your dog's regular collar. For more tips and tricks or information on martingale collars and all sorts of other dog training information, you can check us out at houndgames.com. Thanks for watching.